Hi everyone, my name is Andreas and in this video I will show you how to download and process the free global surface water dataset using QGIS. If you've not yet seen part 1, I encourage you to do so. The QGIS skills we will cover here apply to any raster dataset. We'll be practicing the following key skills which you need to know if you want to work with raster data. Setting up a virtual raster for data processing. Merging and clipping raster datasets. Editing raster symbology. Saving the output as a permanent raster. Working with QGIS Layer Style files to control raster symbology. And finally, creating a map from a template and printing it to PDF. I hope that you will enjoy it and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more exciting videos. Welcome to QGIS 101, Online Water Resources Data. Today we're going to continue looking at the global surface water dataset, and we're going to download some of the data and process it in QGIS to make a map like the one you can see here on the right. So the first thing we need to do is select our data. We'll go to the website, I'll leave a link in the description below. So before we download the data, please have a close look at the license and also the citation requirements. If you use this data in a report, you should really put this somewhere so that people can see where you got the data from. And if we use it to make a map, we should also put somewhere that the source is ecjrc/google. Okay, now the data is stored in 10x10 degree files. And today we're gonna have a look at Afghanistan. So I think it is this tile here. As soon as we've clicked on it, we can download the data. You'll notice that there's a separate TIFF file for each of the six different maps, and you're going to have to download them all separately unless you want to play with Python scripts. Another very important thing is to download the symbology files. In QGIS they're called QML files, and there's a separate one for each of the six different maps. If you have any colorblind people in your audience, you might also consider downloading these ones here. Now, the very important thing are the metadata files, which describe the data. So download all of these as well. Okay, we have downloaded our data. The next step is to open QGIS and look at the data. Okay, here we are in QGIS. I've opened a new project. And I've put all the data in rasters as they are TIFF files and potentially quite heavy. So today we're going to have a look at the transitions map. So let's load one of them. And to have a better idea which area is covered, I'm going to open from GeoPackage the Afghanistan extents and the country boundary. Also, to help us in our navigation, we'll add the Google Terrain Hybrid, which is one of my favorite maps. It's the last one I've added, so it's jumped to the top of the queue. We're going to put it at the bottom here. And now we can see which part of Afghanistan is covered by data. And you'll see that this tile only covers the northwest part. And we're missing here the eastern part and a bit of the south here. So what we're gonna have to do is load another three tiles, one to the right, one to the bottom, and one on the bottom right. So that is our step four, download any missing datasets. Okay, now I've just added the other three data tiles. So now we're covering the whole area of interest, which is inside this red rectangle here. And now we have four raster files, and if we want to work on them, that means we have to do the same work four times, which is not very smart. So actually, what we're going to do is to create a virtual raster. So you go to Raster, Miscellaneous, Build Virtual Raster. First thing we need to do is load our raster datasets. So these four here, press OK, unselect this option here, which is to place each input file into a separate band. And run. It's quite fast, and it has produced a file here called output. So what we can do now is we can just remove the other layers, because actually everything has been put into this virtual raster file. It's not really a raster file, it's more like a catalog of the existing rasters. You have to be very careful because this is a temporary file, so if we close down our project, it's going to get itself deleted. But it's very useful to use a virtual raster layer, because it means that we can quickly do all our processing, and when we're finished, we save it as a final raster file. The next step is to extract part of the virtual raster. We go to raster, extraction, clip raster by mask layer. And you can see it has already chosen the virtual raster layer as the input layer and the mask layer as Afghanistan extents, which is the red rectangle, which we'll use to clip our data with. So we just run it and go get ourselves a cup of coffee, because it's going to take a little bit of time. Okay, so it has completed in just over 400 seconds. And if we switch the other one off, we can see it's clipped the rasters into one output layer. It's still called output. We have to be careful that it doesn't confuse us here. I'm just going to rename this one. Transitions map, and remove this one, because we don't need it anymore. So the next step is to edit the raster symbology. If we double click on here and go to symbology, you'll see that the value of the raster and the label is the same, which is a bit confusing because we don't actually know what these colors mean. So what we'll do is we will load the style which we've downloaded before for transitions, open, and now you can see that each of the colors has a sensible label, so we actually understand what they're trying to say. One thing you'll notice is that there are a lot of black colors here which don't actually have any meaning. They're not used in the map. So let's just delete them. Otherwise, in our legend, we're going to have a very long legend, which look a bit strange. So we select them all, press the red negative, and here we go. Everything is okay. So I'll just say apply, okay. And one thing you might have noticed is that there are a lot of white areas here. So we can't see our nice Google Terrain Hybrid map below it. Let's switch off this white color, which means not water. Just double click on it. And there's various ways to do this. One is to reduce the opacity to 0%. For the hackers amongst us, put two zeros here at the end and press OK. Or another way is just to click Change Opacity and do it this way. Okay, if I press Apply now, you'll see that we can see our Google Terrain map underneath. And what we'll do is we're going to save this style. So save style, and we'll call it Transitions Transparent. Save. Yes, I created this one earlier. Apply and OK. And there we go. Let's have a look at our map. Very nice. You can see those areas that have changed, and where there's never been any water, it is now totally transparent. Okay, so the next step is to save it as a permanent raster file. So just right-click our layer, export, save as, and it will be in GeoTIFF format. Let's call it transitions version 1_1/2019, which is the official name of the other layers. and we check that the extent is correct. It is basically the same as our Afghanistan extents rectangle. And while we're here, we might as well create some pyramids. We will use the cubic resampling method, and let's select a couple of these. And press OK. Go get yourself another cup of coffee. It's going to take a little bit of time. Okay, it's finished processing and everything is black and white. Don't panic. Just load the style. Load style, the transparent one we made earlier, and everything looks fine. You'll notice that we can zoom in and out much faster than before. And the reason for this is that we've made the pyramids. Okay, I'm going to zoom in to the Kajaki Reservoir because we're going to try to make a map of that in the rest of this program. If I can find it, I think it's up here somewhere. Yes, here we go. This is the Kajaki Reservoir on the Helmand River Basin. Okay, we've loaded the layer style. Now we're going to load the map template. Just go to Projects, Layouts. Okay, there's no template here at the moment. We have to go to Layout Manager and have a look down here. A3 Landscape Template, Create from Template, and it's already called it the Kajaki Dam Transitions Map, which I left there earlier. Here we go. Our map is ready. One thing we need to do is to make sure that it is based on the map extent. So just click on the map, item properties, and click on this button here. And another thing is that it seems to have loaded a lot of legends, which we don't actually need. And maybe that is because we still have this layer opened here. I'm going to remove it. And let's have another look at our map. There we go. The legend looks a lot better. So all we need to do now is to add the map title, which is Kajaki Dam Surface Water Transition Map. And we'll put our data source in here just to show some respect. And another thing is we might want to change the names here of who drew it, checked it, and approved it. Maybe put a date, date as well. And then all we need to do is to print the map. Export as PDF. And we're going to put it on our desktop, press save, and save. Wait a few seconds, and it is complete. So while we're waiting, just check that there's nothing else to do. Okay, here's the PDF, which we've just produced in a couple of seconds. It is already laid out according to our standard, with a nice logo here, a disclaimer, in case people think that we're responsible for international boundaries. We have a legend and a north arrow, and of course our scale bar down here, which is all automatic. So I hope that you found this little video interesting and informative, and I thank you very much for your attention.